Hello, folks. Getting started on YouTube, and I think Twitch is warming up here. Today, I'm going to draw a punk rock album cover for my son's band. It's actually the third album cover. Twitch going in a moment, so give it a couple more minutes. Still waiting on Twitch. To be slow. Looks like Twitch is slow today. Online. Yes, punk rock album cover. Sometimes I deviate from editorial cartoons and do something different. And, it's my son's album cover. Looks like Twitch isn't working. See if we can get this sorted out real quick. I'm going to stop the stream and start it up again, see if we can get Twitch working, so excuse me, and I will be right back. Hello, folks. Still trying to get Twitch online. Ah, Twitch is working, and YouTube is working, and I think we're all good. Good to go. Okay. Sorry for that little interruption. So, just a bit of background here. So this is my son's logo that goes on the CD cover, and I'm going to redraw that so that it's a hand-drawn logo rather than the typeface. And this is a little bit of background. This is the last CD cover I did for him, Death Steers the Train. And another previous one, Honeybee Jackson. So this is going to be in the same ilk. It's going to be line art with lots of crosshatch and probably no color, or else he's only going to use color for the A in the logo. And this is the image that he wants. Although I think what I'm going to do here is, hello, Two Senseless. I think I'm going to turn him so that we've got a face showing. It should be an angry face. And I'm going to play around with the guitar a bit. I think I actually print out the guitar when I get a sense of just how big the guitar needs to be. I'm going to print it out from a photo and actually stick it on here and trace it so that I'm sure I get all the guitar details right, because I'm not a music guy and I don't know my guitar details, so I have to make sure that I get it right. So, hey, everybody, chat. I'm going to be sitting here for quite a while. From start to finish, draw the CD cover and do the logo. So off I go. Let's see, did I set my glasses down somewhere? I'm always reminded of how I'm so much older than I should be to be on Twitch, and I need the reading glasses. Just a second, let me grab them. I'll be right back. So it's always something you don't expect, huh? Alright, here I am. I'm ready to go. So, punk rockin'. This is gonna need to be about a big square. And I'm gonna need space at the top for the logo. Opera. Now I need to draw a character filling the space. And unlike this photograph, it needs to fit into this wider than tall space to show face and some expression. And I need to separate the legs and show 2 feet and get better definition on the hands and show a bunch of attitude, because this is punk rock, you know, it's attitude. I'm going to be here a while. Looks like I'm going to need to have the guitar pretty much fill the space from here to here. I'll make the character fit around the guitar. How big is that? Ruler. That looks like 10.5 inches. Is that going to be 10.5 inches? Print that out full size. Give me just a second. Let me get this printed out. Work with. 2 Senseless writes, ha ha. Baby Dollamb writes, agreed. That may be the oldest ruler I've ever seen. Well, you know, rulers don't go bad. Perfectly good ruler. Goes with my reading glasses and my inappropriate for Twitch age, huh? Okay, let's put this out. So, you know, when you have to get precise details like this, and the guitar is important, well, not what I intended to print out. It's printing every page. That's the trouble with real time. Okay, here's the guitar. Guitar's looking good. Too Senseless! Daryl, that Trump baby chair piece turned out great! Thank you, Too Senseless. That's nice of you to say. I'm gonna turn the printer off. I need to make sure I get the bottom edge of this guitar. Correct. It has a particular width. Boy, this stuff was... I'll do the old man talk again. This stuff was much harder to do in the old days before you could just print a photo out on your printer at whatever size you need. used to have what they call a lucigraph, which was a gizmo that would project from underneath for when you had to do these kinds of precise, get every little detail in the right place things. And that's something nobody has any need for anymore. I had this great big gizmo. I would stand in it like a phone booth. Project this stuff up from underneath. Particular to logos and things that you have to trace and get just right. Like this particular guitar, which must be this guitar. Set up. There's my scrap again. Here's his guitar. Guitar is going to be big. It goes kind of straight, doesn't it? Not so much. Needs a little more tilt up. Yeah, let's go with that. Now I will draw around the guitar. I actually should, I'm not going to draw around the logo because the logo I'm going to draw separately because he's going to need the logo for other things. I'll drop the logo in with Photoshop. Okay, now his head. It's about here, isn't it? Down to the back. His arm on his shoulder. Going down. Let's get the elbow back here. He wants to be skinnier. And has to come all the way down to here, huh? So the elbow can't be quite that high. See, I have photoscrap of his hand position here. I have to get the hand position right too. But to rotate this, you rotate. Get rotating it. Just freehand it. Comes to here and is covering up this part. And it's actually as big as most of that. So, and it's bigger. Son should be watching this. Michael, say something. All right. Here's his pick. And go up. Way. Second finger. That one. see what goes on with the other hand. Other hand is, needs to be the same size. Grip is going to come at the top. Silent. Not as much fun stuff to talk about as when I'm doing a political cartoon, huh? Down this way. But, on here. Oh, and he needs a wire coming out. Baby Dalam writes that. Poor pencil! Poor pencil. Pencil lives for this. So this is the rough sketch, and when I finish the rough sketch, I'm going to put a piece of vellum over this. And do the finished line art on the vellum. His neck and face is going to come out that way. Here is I'm going to make up this entirely because he's showing no face and his hair is just a big ball of bloop. Baby Dalian says she's playing Blade and Soul and she can just hear the scratching of the pencil. You know, I don't play music or anything. I just talk all the time like a Popeye mumbling to myself, and the only sound effects that you get, aside from the folks working next door building a house going clank clank clank, we're kind of quiet right now, is it's all scraping, and I think the pencil scraping is an important sound effect to give you the whole dimensionality of the look over Daryl's shoulder experience. I think that needs to go out that way. Never want to accept a photograph as being right, because the drawing has to be more right. This thumb. Baby Dalam is just messing with me. No comments yet from YouTube. his internal structure is. So he's got face here, and a little space with the hand. I'll have to think through the hair a little bit. I think the logo is going to go through his hair. I need to squash and stretch him a bit to get him into the space. I'm going to need to do is have his legs go out this way to show some shoes. I'm kind of running out of space, aren't I? He wants to have particular shoes. Skinny up the legs to fit him in, huh? So, comments. People don't have anything to say here. When I draw the guitar, it is naturally going to get bigger. Just the way I draw, everything gets bigger. Map it out so that it's not quite as big as it's going to be. Senseless writes, Daryl, do you have any tips for drawing caricatures? Everything is kind of the same way that you see me do it, too, Senseless. I spend a lot of time futzing things around with my sketch to try to get it right. Just keep looking back and back and back again at the caricatures to make sure they really look like them. And they don't, you draw them over and over again until you get them right. Don't have to be like like the caricature guy at the carnival. Gets him right every time because he's not doing anything very ambitious with his caricature. This is the space I need to fill. This leg, it goes up. This power cord needs to have a little more interesting filling the space more appropriately. Two Senseless Rights. Do your kids draw too? Yes, my daughter Susie is quite the editorial cartoonist journalist. This one is for Michael, who is the could draw very well. He's got talent, but he doesn't spend the time with it that's necessary to develop your talent. He spends his time on music. Requires the same time commitment. Happy with the way I'm getting the feed in. the shoe over here. That's better. In the back of the shoe here. The shoe down here. Okay. Scrap of this shoe on my phone. Oh, there it is. The shoe. Notorious shoe. Not like that. Face. I'm going to need to pay more attention to that hand. This hand kind of works. Hey, you new folks coming in watching, come say hello. Chat, don't be quiet. Sitting here all afternoon drawing this. No one has anything to say on YouTube. Alright, head. And obscure some hair. Heinz 235 writes, "Hey, Mr. Cagle, I finally caught you. You are amazing, my friend." Oh, well, excellent. Oh, just a second. Excuse this loud noise. That should improve the sound. Sorry, I hadn't moved my microphone close enough to my face. Two Senseless writes, "Just mesmerized by your drawing process." Oh, excellent. Well, it takes a long time, so good that you're mesmerized. All right, he wants to be angry. This is punk rock. Punk rock is angry, huh? So, angry. I appreciate you being here, Heinz235. Please go subscribe or send a note to your friends, because I need to get more followers on Twitch in order to be taken seriously. I'm not getting many people to look in. Too new to this, I guess. He wants to have grit and teeth. Just a second here. Dealing with phone stuff. Okay, actually that kind of looks like it as well. A little bit of collar poking up over his face is okay. Heinz writes, did you start off with a thumbnail before you began? Yes! In fact, my son and I discussed this at dinner last night, and this is the thumbnail drawn on a napkin. And so, there's the thumbnail! Two Senseless writes, you should set up a simple alert to notify you of new followers. Nothing too crazy, just something simple. Baby Doll Am agrees. Yes, but I must say I have so few followers that it's not going to chime very often, but of course you're right, I should do that. Anticipating that this will be more popular. I'm the only editorial cartoonist I know who's doing this. I don't think it's going to be easy to get other people to do it either. Because it's kind of hard to get this set up looking right. And it's a commitment to be willing to mumble through it all the time. And I think if I don't talk, I watch other people's streams where they don't talk, and I want them to talk. Oh, thank you, Too Senseless. Yeah, be sure you subscribe or follow or like. I appreciate it. One thing that a lot of cartoonists don't do that I think is important is they don't think about the actual shape of the teeth, you know, the four square ones and the canines being round, and when you have a big gritty teeth thing going on, and you can show farther teeth back, it really helps to round out the back teeth so that they look like their back teeth. He's looking pretty angry. My son wants angry. Ears should be between your eyebrow and the bottom of your nose. It needs to terminate there. Heinz235 writes, I'm already subscribed to your Twitch and YouTube account. Do you work out of your home? Yes, I'm sitting at home right here. That's angry, huh? It kind of looks like him. A little bit harsh because he's not an angry guy. Although his music is pretty angry. Maybe he's a deceptively angry guy. He's not such an angry guy. My son and I had a discussion about the face. He wanted to go with just a mop of hair and no face, and I think that's a mistake because people are always going to hone in on the eyeballs. And if you have no face, you've lost a lot of power for expression in the drawing. So I think it's important to have a face. Heinz writes, is this a personal project you're working on as a side gig? This is my son's punk rock album cover for his punk rock opera. And I have done album covers for him before. Let me show you that. So that's one of the first ones I did for him, Death Steers the Train. And then I did this one, which was... when he was a honeybee Jackson. So, yeah, I was kind of happy with this Death Steer, this is a train one. One thing that is difficult for non-artists to accept is that the simpler the art, the more powerful the art, and it can be difficult to get people to accept that. They think, oh, put in this and put in this and put in this, and the more you put in, the lousier your art is. It needs to be simple. So, today is a departure from the editorial cartooning. Today is punk rock day. Heinz235 writes, Is that 235 because it's like uranium 235 is what you make a bomb out of? Just wondering why the 235. Wow, do you typically use the same process in coming up with your ideas, or do they vary? Well, this idea is one that came from my son, and he wanted to have that kind of position. And so we negotiated a little bit about adding a face and making it fit. So, sorry. Sometimes I forget to turn the camera back. Alright. All this blank space up here should be filled with punk rocker hair. I'm going to need to think a little bit as I do the hair about how I want the light to hit it and where the areas of shadow are going to be. Because you can't just draw a bunch of lines for hair. They have to have light source and dark areas. So yeah, Theo, I should have a cute little animation for when people follow on Twitch. That would be nice. Have to sit down and make that work. All right. I thought my son would be watching this, and he would say, "My hair doesn't look like that." But since he's not, he's gonna get whatever I draw, huh? Ah, thank you, baby doll I am. Okay, down here is really where you should run the name of the album, huh? And it should be small. It should run right across here in the corner. Punk rock opera. This background is going to resolve to black. Heinz writes, "How do you get your face in front of the drawing? Ha ha, is that a green screen?" Yep, a green screen. That's why I wear this red shirt. This red shirt performs very well with the green screen. And so I put it on when I'm going to do a live stream, and I think people are going to think, "Whoa, Daryl never changes his shirt." This big blank arm is looking kind of dull, isn't it? What can I do about that? He needs elbow. Arm is too thick, I think. That arm's too thick as well. So let's this arm back a little bit. I like doing the album covers, unless it's a crowd scene. Baby Doll M writes, "Theo's the reason I started watching. Side note, you should wear a green shirt one day, ha ha ha, so I can be a floating head." I could put a little box here with the fish tank and float with the fishes. I think I'm going to need to move the symbol on his arm. to make the arm more interesting. Less face, more hair in the face, my son is saying. Michael, you're watching. You should just comment in the comment area. I mean, this is you. Less face. I'm going to have hair covering his face quite a bit. Less face. Mine's 235 writes, I like how you pasted the guitar. I never thought of doing that. Are you going to use the guitar design? Yes, I'm just going to trace the guitar, but I pasted the photo there because I know I need to get every little detail exactly right on the guitar. And so, easier to trace it to know that I get it right than to try to get all of those things in the right positions. This up a little bit, make it fit a little bigger. It needs to go that direction, huh? 1, 2, 3. This is, oh, just so you know, this is what I'm looking at. The scrap my son gave me for what the cover should look like. Okay, this is going to be bigger because the arm is looking big and blank and it's looking like it's a little bit of a problem. It's going to take a bunch of crosshatch to make it more interesting. So this arm altogether is not that interesting. It needs to poke out more that way, I think. Let's think again about what we're doing with this hair. So, now I need the big Sharpie. Remember, I'm not drawing anything to look good here. I'm drawing it to give me direction in doing my final drawing, my overlay, the ink. Look how little face you've got, Michael. People are just going to have to guess that there's a face there. Excuse me. I'm going to need hair shadow. Heinz 235 writes, I'm getting into political cartooning, which is why I started following everything you put out. Do you have any advice for aspiring editorial political cartoonists? Well, you do it for love because the business sucks. And that's not what people want to hear, but I'm afraid it's the cruel reality. Excuse me. So my advice is just go ahead and start, and then once you have a good batch of stuff, pitch it around, try to find a few clients. Little clients are probably all you'll find that you need to, the best thing you can do as a new political cartoonist is try to to find a home for your cartoons so people know where and how to find you. Hey, Michael, Baby Doll Lamb writes, why less face? This was our negotiation. Our negotiation was more face, no, less face. No, more face, no, less face. Boy, nobody has anything to say on YouTube. Theo writes, everyone knows less face, more punk rock. For example, the Ramones. Well, all right. He likes the Ramones. I don't think the punk rockers think about less face. I think most of these rock bands just take a picture on their iPhone, make it a little bit crummy, and put it on their cover. Unless you're Iggy Pop, then face equals punk rock. Baby doll lamb likes the eyes. Good, good. Gotta have eyes. She is correct. I assume baby doll is female. She's pink and her name is baby doll. Never know on Twitch. I think my son is staying off of the chat. Okay. I can probably... Ah, you are a female, baby doll. I think I can probably make... make up for all of this junk that's not working by doing a better job of my final art. This hand is not very nice. Let's see, let's try a new hand here. I'll grab a better piece of paper. Like it's about hand sized, huh? Heinz235 writes, do you have a typical morning routine to prepare you for the day? I usually go out to breakfast and read two newspapers. That's an un-Twitch-like old man thing to say, huh? I read two newspapers. Boy, reading glasses and two newspapers. Tracing paper here. Oh, he had given me that hand position. Let's go back to that. Hand position. Okay, so hand goes thumb. First finger, second finger, third finger, and the little finger. having that little finger point out was not working. Pick goes like that. I think that hand's looking a little better. Ah, Michael, there you are. Matt Cagle is my son who is being depicted here. Nice to see you here chatting, Michael. Michael, who goes by the name Mac. And I call him Michael. I tell you, I haven't really done ad jobs or stuff like that on streaming, and I kind of hate the idea of an art director watching what I do in real time so that he would want to make changes in chat as I go along. Ooh, a nightmare. I guess here Michael is the art director, huh? Good to see you here, Michael. So there's your hand with your pick. No. Good for you to be here. So, Michael, as I'm drawing this, I see that the space at the top is pretty premium to where the art is fitting, but I have this open space down here, and I would make your logo tiny and put it down here, or I might also stack it punk, rock, opera, like that in the corner. I think that's stronger, and it interferes less with the artwork. Are you okay with that, Michael, my online art director? Remember, it takes you about a minute and a half to hear what I had to say. Bottom corner is okay. All right, I have go ahead for bottom corner. Okay to stack the logo, or does it have to be wide? Because I can make it bigger. Figure if I stack it punk, rock, opera, or punk, rock, opera, because you can see the space here is kind of a triangle. Oh, thank you on the hand, Heinz 235. Okay. This logo turns out to be kind of important to deal with this space. Ah, okay, good. Thank you, Michael. We'll stack the logo. Actually, that's something I didn't think of until I started drawing this and seeing how hard it is to squeeze you into a square. So with that in mind, I think I may give you more hair going back this way. This is more hair than you actually have. But there's no point in having long hair that isn't expressive. Well, Mike, I'm not really looking at the phone over here, so getting in mullet territory, huh? You don't want it down here on the back of the neck? That's too much. Mullet. Let's not shorten the front. Let's get rid of this. No, not shorten the front at all. Okay, I think maybe I'm ready to go to finish here. Baby doll lamb. No, he's telling me I've got too much hair, but he's gonna have a lot of, he needs a lot of hair. So, Michael, I'm not getting a lot of detail opportunity in here because it's so well covered up by the guitar. So that detail stuff that you gave me from the front of your jacket, I think, is not quite fitting. That knee can go up a little bit farther. Hair's okay, Michael? Good. All right. I think he's got lots of action. Then again, the background's going to be black. So I need to draw the black. Okay, I am done with my rough sketch, and I'm going to go to finish here. So that's going to take longer than my rough sketch. Sketch so far has taken more than an hour. You know, I think maybe you got too much torso going on here. I need to pull that in here. Take another look at that. Let's make that go. That way, make sure that I'm defining a difference with the arm there. It's a little better. Okay. See if I can get his hand first. Hand at the top of the guitar. So nobody ever, that's on YouTube. Punk rock opera. Lamb writes, most people use Twitch now. Well, here I am. Twitch started doing their creative community last October, so it's still new. And for old codgers like me, I'm not seeing my colleagues doing this yet. I think most of the cartoonists are going to think that it's pretty stressful to commit to drawing live. Commit to live chatting with people while you're drawing. Show all of your mistakes and all of your process. And then to try to build an audience, because there are not very many people watching this. Okay. Yeah, this is gonna take a while. Lots of precise details on here. In case you're wondering, I have a piece of sandpaper over here to the right that I use to make the chisel point that I like best on my pencil. Heinz235 writes, I noticed you only color digitally. Have you ever started a drawing digitally? Yeah, I use the Wacom tablet for my coloring. And lots of cartoonists will use the Wacom tablet for their drawing as well, but I like having original art, and I like my drawings better with pencil rather than the more minimal way that they tend to look when I draw them originally on the Wacom. Also, I sell originals. Seems to me like you've given up an income source when you commit to drawing things. You lose all that nice original art. So yeah, I do my finishes in pencil. But I think they look like nice original art because I like this vellum paper, and it looks quite nice as an original. I know some artists argue that it's faster. You don't have to scan it when you're done. You don't have to clean up all the little crud that you always get in an original drawing. There are advantages to it. But this is my choice. My choice is old-fashioned pencil. How do you go about selling your original work? Do you attend conventions? No, just every so often somebody emails me and wants to buy something. But I don't make an effort to sell them. I don't sell that many. Sometimes I'll hear from a politician. When a politician calls wanting to hang a cartoon of himself on the wall like a trophy, I tell them to donate $800 to the National Multiple Sclerosis Society. And usually, that makes them go away because I think they are just interested in hearing you say, "Oh, I'm so flattered that you want to hang my cartoon on your wall. Let me just send it to you for free." And those guys are often quite cheap. Two senseless rights. It's hard to mimic the look of pencil pen in digital form. It doesn't feel the same. Yeah, that's how I feel about it. They're a little close together. Michael. I think I've got a little bit of manga expression going on with you here, Michael. You're looking like manga. To stop and think, where's the light source? Where's the movement? And I find that that sometimes interferes with my Popeye-like babbling. Oh, it's the hair that makes him look like manga, huh? There's too much hair. Yeah, I think so. Bottom of the nose isn't quite as elegant as it should be. So you think I remind you of Paul Conrad Hines? That's a compliment. I like Paul Conrad. He's one of the greats. Yeah, his mouth going off in one direction is kind of manga-like as well, huh? So, Michael, what do you think about all this manga stuff that's going on here without my real planning? I like doing the departures from the editorial cartoons. It's nice to do something different. I think I'd like to do more of the occasional ad work, album cover stuff, which I tend not to do because I tend to get in the same rut of just doing cartoons all the time. You don't think it looks like manga, huh, Michael? You don't think you look like Ash in this? Maybe a little bit like Elf from The Hobbit? Lots of hair going on. Looks like it's gonna kind of end up being about the hair, huh? This stuff just kind of happens as you draw it. I hadn't planned for it to be all about the hair. hands, eyes, and teeth are signature. So it looks like Cagle. Okay. I don't know. I don't have much eyes going on there. I think you're looking a little bit like an elf. I could give a pointy ear here, and you would be elfin. Elfin. Do you ever struggle with capturing the original sketch? How do you maintain the sketch quality? Well, my big trick for that is drawing in pencil instead of ink, because the ink tends to stiffen me up. And pencil keeps me loose. So the finish, I'm not drawing the original sketch to look nice. I'm drawing it just to give me, to solve the positional problems, work everything out before I do the final line art that I'm doing now. Shannara Chronicles punk rock. Shannara Chronicles. You happy with your face, Michael? Thank you. Ah, good face. Good, good. You are looking angry. How often do I do these live tutorials? Interesting you call it a tutorial, because it's just drawing the stuff I have to draw today. I should make myself do more. I'm going to try to make myself do just about all of my drawings on a live feed. I have debated about whether to do my coloring on a live feed. And I probably should. I need to buy a couple more cameras because I have to move the face camera and readjust it to do color, which I need a separate face camera for when I'm working on the computer. Haven't gotten around to do that. Theo's telling me I should do the color in Photoshop because I should be on the Adobe channel. Yep. All right. I'll do it. I need to buy a new camera so I don't have to futz around for 40 minutes making the new setup look right. And of course you are right, Theo. How many drawings do I attempt to finish a day? Writes Heinz 235. I usually do 2 to 3 editorial cartoons a week. This is not typical because I usually just do my editorial cartoons, although I like these departures and doing some different things every so often. Next project, draw a streaming schedule graphic. I should do that. You know, Theo, what I would like is to have a graphic that pops up on all the sites that says Daryl will do his next stream in so many minutes at such an clock at this address. And then maybe a countdown clock. Countdown to Daryl doing his stream. That would be nice. I think I'm coming up on an hour and 35 minutes. I think I'm not entirely happy with your right or left eye. Let's give that one another try. See how that one grows on me. You are very, very angry, Michael. Michael writes, "Eee! Is that an expression of approval or disgust?" Hey, can you play a sample of his music while you draw? I'd love to hear it. Hey, Michael, I think what you need to do is put a link to your music in chat so that people can click on it and know where to follow you. Hey, seeing as I showed everybody this this Death Steers the Train that I drew for you before. How about to put a link up to Death Steers the Train? Ah, thank you for the link, Michael. Lots of hatching going on. Thanks for those links, Michael. Thank you. Maybe this is one of those instances where I should be playing music while I do this. But I don't like watching other people's streams that have music. I just turn the sound off and then I don't hear them say anything. Black Flag or BR? Yes, I think Michael had the old Black Flag in mind. So he tells me. Suicidal tendencies. I think Michael's mentioned that as well. Back in the 80s, when I lived in Manhattan, the building I lived in the village, had a big rock club in the basement, in the ground floor of the building called the Ritz. And they had the punk rockers go there. I wasn't far from the old CBGBs. And I'm sure the Ramones played there. I remember one time the whole street in front of my apartment was a mob of people. And I thought, my God, what's going on? It's the apocalypse. And what it was the police playing downstairs in my building. Not only did they fill up the Ritz, they filled up all the surrounding streets. So back in my youth, I would sometimes venture into the Ritz. They had a design motif of a chain link fence inside. I didn't care for the CBGBs, because that struck me as being more of a filled with Hell's Angels kind of place. So to see it so revered now is kind of funny. For me, I would walk down the block, look in there, and walk right out because it was not a welcoming environment. Whereas the Ritz wasn't a scary place, it was just quite loud. Michael and I have had discussions about why bands don't have nice art on their covers anymore like they did more back in the 80s in my day. And I think maybe we can blame the iPhone for that. The casual crummy photographer that didn't used to exist because crummy photography wasn't quite as easy. guy from ST. Yeah, I don't know my punk rock. Cassette tape killed the album cover, Theo? Huge to tiny. Yep. Although, you gotta admit, at the same time that we lost the art on the album covers, we also lost the art in movie posters. And those didn't get tiny. Theo, it's interesting that I haven't gotten a single comment from YouTube, although it looks like YouTube is working fine, just not someplace where people are finding me. Not as good a crowd as we've had in the past on Twitch as well. So, I'm coming up on 2 hours here. Theo advises me that when I hit the 2 hour mark, I should stop the stream, take a break, and restart it because 2 hours for a video is too long on YouTube. So I may run off for a 10-minute break, a 5-minute break. Restart the stream. Not sure I'm happy with your upper lip here, Michael. We do pretty well at getting people to look at the videos after I'm done with the stream. Kidding, on the different, add up the different platforms where I post it, getting about 1,000 people to look at each one. But harder to get people to come in real time and sit here and chat. And it's nice to have people respond, nice to have a chat. So, hey, for you folks that are just joining now, and I see some of you joining, what I'm doing here is, punk rock CD cover for my son's rock band, and this is a previous album cover I did for him, and yet another previous album cover that I did for him. So it's along the same lines as what I've done before. Oh, comments on YouTube. John H. has appeared. Nice to see you, John. Or is that an old comment? An old comment. Kim G, we're out here. Just a mom watching you draw. My daughter has been drawing forever. Wants to be an artist. Husband's bringing home dinner, and I find drawing fascinating. Especially people with that gift. Oh, well, thank you very much, Kim G. Heinz 235, your first time in a... in a live stream on Twitch, really? Are you a gamer? Do you go to Twitch for the regular Twitch stuff? Okay. Do I want to use a ruler to get the strings on the... I'm not sure I do. Just freehand the strings. Oh, well, that's pretty crummy. Get rid of this. It would be nice if there was something that would show up on Twitch that would show me how many people are watching. I get that on YouTube. Eight people watching on YouTube. Draw on your monitor, Heinz 235. Are you a cartoonist? Do you have a Wacom tablet? Well, those strings I'm drawing are not looking right, are they? Excuse me. You got the Twitch account just to watch me, Heinz? Oh, I'm flattered. Well, be sure to follow me on Twitch. I appreciate that. You know, I might pull out that antique ruler and use that for these strings. think I will. Excuse me, my hay fever. Oh, change the view, you're right. Yeah, sorry about that. Yeah, I think the real time is nice. Heinz 235. I would hope this can catch on. Jury is still out on that because, excuse me, I'm not sure I have a big enough audience to justify the trouble of doing this, so I don't know that other artists are going to want to follow in my footsteps unless I demonstrate some success here in gathering an audience. So I think the other editorial cartoonists will be watching my experience. Too senseless. Okay, I'm back a little late, but if I hear Adobe Channel is looking for new streamers, you'll be the first to know. The chat is very interactive. It will boost your viewers on your own channel. Well, thank you. Let's see if we can make that happen. Excuse me. If I wasn't talking to you guys, I'd be listening to Fox News. Well, I tell you, when I look at that Adobe Creative section, I flip through them down through the bottom to see who's watching what. And, I would think that this drawing should make for an interesting feed that should draw more people than it does. It's interesting. Sometimes I draw something that requires a little bit too much brain, and I can tell that my Popeye-like mumbly part of my brain needs to give way to my drawing part of my brain to draw some particular thing. Brain cells collide. Excuse the hay fever. coffin for a couple of months, which I don't understand because it's rainy winter time. Why should I have hay fever? Kim G writes on YouTube, maybe since last week this time, a good portion of the country was cooped inside for a couple of days. Maybe everybody's out enjoying their freedom. Well, if there were more artists who do the kind of stuff that I like, live streaming on Twitch, my favorite editorial cartoonists and such, I would keep a window of their desktop open all the time. I would enjoy seeing my colleagues' desktops. Excuse me. I think that would be great fun. Okay, I forget who it was called this a tutorial. I guess suppose it is. The best way to learn is to watch somebody else draw, and you've got a better view than standing back over my shoulder. Because the camera is right here in front of my nose. All right, I'm up to 2 hours and 4 minutes. I'm going to have to stop the video for a minute and take a bathroom break and make sure that we get a second YouTube video going, because 2 hours is too long. And so what I'm going to do is don't go away. I will be back in just about 5 minutes or so, and the stream will resume. And so stay where you are, keep your stream open, it will start again. So thank you much, and I think I probably got another 2 hours to go on this one. So I look forward to spending the rest of the afternoon with you. Thank you, folks. Hello, folks. I'm back, starting the stream up again. Looks like the stream is just about ready to start. All right, I'm live on YouTube, and Twitch should be starting up again in just a second. So here I am continuing the punk rock opera cover, which is My Son the Rocker. And here you can see what I'm working on. This will be him squeezed into a square for a CD cover. And here you can see what has gone before. This was his previous album cover, and the one before that I did. So back on the new one. He wants this position, but can't quite fit that position in, but I'm getting as close as I can to keeping it in the square. So that is the goal. Action, but squeezed into a square. But with the generally the same jumping kind of position. So, I think I'm going to work on his hand right now. Thank you for sticking with me, folks. I presume that Twitch is working again. I don't have a Twitch window open. I have just the chat. Let's see, Michael gave me the hand position that he absolutely wanted, which was this. That's the hand position he's looking for. Guess I'm kind of getting there. Close enough. This is more crosshatch detail than I can get away with in an editorial cartoon. Editorial cartoons have to be drawn with a little bit of lowest common denominator in mind. Lowest common denominator being how small is it going to be printed? Oops. Kim G writes, so forgive me if you've already mentioned this. How much of your skill is God-given and how much from formal instruction? Well, there's some formal instruction there, but, you know, most of what happens to get you to draw well is practice. And when I was little, I collected comics and drew my own comic books in the superheroes. And I tell ya, that is the same history that most cartoonists have, is the comic books and superheroes and sitting on the floor drawing your superheroes. And kids these days play video games instead of sitting and drawing their comics. And I notice when I look at the web comics and stuff of all the stick figures and the seeming lack of value placed on drawings, traditional drawing skills, that I think that's a bit disappointing. That's another old man thing to say, huh? Sometimes I say things like that, and my daughter says, stop saying that! It's an old man thing to say. So, if you would, folks, please subscribe to me on Twitch. I would much appreciate that. Because I'm just trying to build an audience here, and that seems to be kind of slow going. I find that the people who visit our Cagle.com site are interested in looking quickly through a bunch of cartoons. Not particularly interested in sitting with me all afternoon while I draw the punk rock CD cover. But you know, a heck of a lot of the cartoonist's life is sitting all day long drawing on stuff. That takes longer than people think it should be taking you to do such a thing. Oh, now that I've drawn that hand, I can tear it off and see the guitar underneath. Hand came out a little bigger than I thought it would. Bring up the guitar again. Alright, that's what I'm looking at. The guitar has to be black. So, excuse me for sitting silently here. But you guys are silent. So chat with me, folks. You got nothing to say? I thought when I was doing my editorial cartoons on the live stream on Twitch that I would have lots of comments about politics. People would be arguing politics. And interestingly, that didn't happen. People have how-to kind of questions. Perhaps you folks think arguing about politics on Twitch is rude, but I tell ya, I think part of it is that just it's not a topic of conversation that you hear a lot among the age demographic of people that are on Twitch. Just doesn't come up. Huh? Heinz235 writes, "Hey Daryl, has there been any big events that have inspired your work? A lot has been going on this year." I'm more inspired when there's something that makes me angry. And I guess there's plenty to make you angry these days, huh? I have a couple of, I usually have a list of editorial cartoon ideas that are waiting in line for the next one to be drawn, and if I was drawing for a daily newspaper again, and I had to put out one cartoon a day, you know, I'd be drawing more of those cartoons from the list that don't quite make it up to the number one spot and get drawn. So the two that are waiting to be drawn right now is I want to draw, and I may not draw that because a better idea will come along, but I was thinking of drawing Donald Trump standing next to Ted Cruz, pointing at Ted Cruz's crotch. Ted Cruz is naked, and over his crotch he has the Canadian maple leaf, and Donald Cruz pointing at his maple leaf junk. That strikes me as kind of funny. You know, the cartoonists have a kind of a professional obligation. If you've got a gag about a politician that you can draw either naked or cross-dressing or as a dog peeing on something, kind of have an obligation to do that one. I do look for the excuses to draw the politicians naked. And I'm kind of surprised that I haven't seen anybody else doing maple leaf. Oh boy, my chroma key. You know what happens with that is it gets later in the day and the lighting through the windows changes. So let me correct the chroma key and then we will get back to my favorite subject matter to draw. Boy, chroma key is just getting rowdy. Okay, I think, oh boy. Give me a minute. I can't have this happening. But stream is back online. We should be good again. If you stuck with me, I appreciate it. My apologies for the technical difficulties. Raspy CS, nice beard. Oh, thank you. Looks like you guys popped back. Nice to see you here again. Sorry about the interruption as I tried to fix my squirrely chroma key changing as the sunlight changes in the room.
OBS decided it was time to quit. Stinking program crashed 3 times. The OBS for PCs is much better than the OBS for Mac. I think the whole idea of doing this streaming on a Mac is an afterthought. Everything is designed for gamers with PCs. And not only are the functions on the Mac version of OBS lousy compared to the PC version, but the program is not entirely stable. So once in a while it decides it just wants to quit. My apologies. It does better when you get it working the first time and then you don't touch it. But, you know, the light changes through the day, the chroma key decides to become squirrely. Gotta deal with it. The problem is that streams keep buffering, I believe, writes D3&3. Nice to see you here, D3&3. Actually, I think the stream is working pretty well today. I'm not getting dropped frames, and it looks pretty clean. I think the problem is not the stream. I think the problem is the darn OBS program is just... not as stable on a Mac as it should be. But sometimes it gets into a little mood where it's constructive, and you don't futz with it, then it stays. I think it's back in a little bit of a stable position now until I try to adjust the chroma key again. So if you would, folks, D3&3, please subscribe to me. I appreciate it. I'm not having as much audience as I would like to have here on Twitch. They don't want to pay attention to you or make you a partner until you've got a good number of subscribers. And I kind of think that the people who are editorial cartoon fans are not much into the subscribing to live feeds on Twitch. Oh, thank you, D3&3. I appreciate your support. Yeah, and if anybody is enough of a fan to ask a friend to look in and subscribe, that would be very nice too. I would appreciate that. Yeah, drawing this hair like this is something that's taking that part of my brain that I need to mumble. He needed a bunch more hair. The drawing is kind of turning out to be about the hair. Looks like I lost some people when I had that OBS failure. I'm not sure I'm happy with his nose and his snuff box. Yeah, right. OBS crashed on you? Yes, crashed about 4 times in a row there. What happened, Theo, was the sun is setting, and so the room got darker. I needed to adjust the chroma key and that was enough to make the OBS crash. D3&3, how long have you been streaming since, date-wise? I'm still pretty new to this. I haven't been consistent about streaming, so I did a couple of tests, and it's only recently that I've been trying to stream all the drawings, so I'd say about a couple of weeks of streaming all the drawings. But, a bit more practice before that, trying to get things to work, because it's kind of challenging. Not only is it technically challenging, particularly on a Mac, but it's creatively challenging to try to sit here and chat all the time while I'm drawing. Hey Theo, do you get a measure of how many people are watching on Twitch? I only get a number on YouTube. Most people are so silent. Kind of nice to know how many people are there watching silently. Eight people watching on Twitch. Oh, all right. It's a silent eight. Interesting shine that we get here from the lights up there. It's one of the things I like about pencil is there's this textural quality that I see here and that you're getting with the light, at least, that is nice. Well, clearly, I get more people looking at these after they're saved as videos than I do people that are willing to sit with the live stream, which is kind of disappointing because I would like to interact with people. So over here on the right side, I have a piece of fine grain sandpaper that I use to give my pencil a chisel point that I like. In case you're wondering what I'm reaching over to the right to do every so often. Marilyn Harmon writes, it takes a while for people to find you. Give it a month or so. Okay. Thank you, Marilyn. Marilyn, do please subscribe to me, because I would like to be a Twitch partner, and they are reluctant to do so for somebody who does not have enough followers. You would think that they would want to take special care to try to cultivate new kinds of artists like editorial cartoonists to come in with all the kids that are drawing manga. But I think they only look at the numbers. Marilyn followed me. Oh, thank you. Theo, we need a cute little animation for when somebody follows. This guy's got a mane. He's starting to be a little bit like, oh shoot, I'm forgetting. Who's the lion guy who was the Kraven the Hunter? Old Marvel guy with the big bunch of hair. So thank you for following me, Marilyn. Oh, thank you, Theo. I would like to have a cute Twitch alert. I noticed the dancing taco. I like the dancing taco. As I draw this, I'm trying to think of which way the shirt goes and which way the lighting is going. I need a drop shadow behind the guitar. I spent much of my career as an advertising illustrator doing illustration jobs like this. Actually, most of the jobs I did were character jobs and toy design. Not many CD covers. A little bit wrong. I've got to get the guitar just right. Brian Indiana Anderson. Twitch will not allow me to log in. Sorry, I'm silent. I like watching because I cannot draw worth beans. Thank you for watching, Brian. Oh, you can You can subscribe to me on YouTube as well. That would be nice. We have 6 people watching on YouTube. My son sent me a photograph of just what it should look like, where the plug sticks into the guitar, if I can find that. I find the stuff on my phone. Okay, here it is. Bigger. Alright, well, that's as big as I'm going to get. That's how the plug goes in. So, straight across there. Little metallic plug. Alrighty. Feral Jew Boy. Hey, Daryl, how are you? I hope you're well. Checking in here from London, England. Nice to see you here, Feral. Feral, be sure to subscribe to me, because I am hurting for subscribers. And I need for Twitch to take me seriously. I think Twitch only takes subscribers seriously. Just poke the picture firmly once, Michael says. Look at this, Michael. Poke the picture firmly once. I have trouble with images in chat. Much better if you email them to me. Anyway, I can't make it big. And likewise, if I email it to myself, it takes about 5 hours to get to me. So, images in chat are not good. Once quickly, you say. Okay, once quickly. Ah! Ha ha ha! Alright. Flip, flip, flip! Alright, that's weird. Oh, it's got a... I didn't realize it had this little screw. Yeah, that's why I needed to blow it up. Okay. Thank you, Michael. For those of you that are new and just joining me now, I'm doing a punk rock CD cover. I see you there, Feral Jew Boy. And this is a rock album cover for punk rock album cover for my son. And this is previous punk rock album cover I did for him. And another previous one with the jazzy B. So this one is more of a portrait of Michael. Well, sorry, Feral, but it looks to me like the stream is working and the problem is all on your end. My test windows are looking good. got a Twitch and a YouTube test open. Do I charge my son for this, or does he get mate's rates? Nah, I'm not charging him for this. This is one of the perks of having a cartoonist dad. Marilyn Harmon says it's buffering there a lot as well. Well, what can I tell you, folks? But the problem's on your end. I've got no buffering in my test windows. So my apologies. I hate to suggest it, but it seems that you might get a better stream if you reduce it to 720 instead of full HD. I hate to suggest that because you're looking at a pencil drawing, you know? You want to see the little details. I've got this all set up so that I think you're seeing pretty darn good focus on the little details. But what can I say? Part of this was that my son sent me this image, which is what he wanted the album to look like, and he wants me to match all the details of the clothes and the position. Kid Scoop News writes, "Hi Daryl, which politician is your favorite to draw, current and or from the past?" Well, I know that this is not going to be a popular answer, but I think the best cartoon character politician of them all is Hillary, because Hillary has so much wonderful history. What you really want from a political cartoon character is for people to have background knowledge, so that it's kind of like Charlie Brown and Lucy in the football. You know that Lucy's gonna pull the football away, and when she does, that's rewarding, because there's something rewarding about a character who does what you expect the character to do. And in the case of Hillary, she's got so much background that so many people are familiar with. It's like I've got a Peanuts character that everybody knows. And I can just have her do what you know she would do and think what you know she would think. I remember she was doing a book tour at the same time as Bill Clinton. And I think they did a book signing together. And so I drew a cartoon about that, which was a wordless cartoon. I had Bill Clinton, he's opening up his book, and it's got the Playboy centerfold, and it drops out. And then Hillary gives him a dirty look and whacks him over the head with her book. And that's the kind of thing that you can only do with characters that are so well known and so well defined that Oh, I didn't draw my tuning knobs, and there they are right there in the photo. All right, Michael, you are absolutely right. I need to go in and fix that and add the tuning knobs. They go in his hair. They are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I'm going to have to do it that way. Make space for the tuning knobs. Brian and Deanna Anderson, right? They need to get a faster connection from their service provider. Yeah, this really is pretty heavy computer use to watch a live stream like this. Not unlike watching your Netflix. But, like I say, you know, turn down the resolution and it'll work fine. Okay, tuning knobs. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. No, you're not causing trouble, Michael. I needed to do the tuning knob, so I just wasn't thinking of it. I think that's okay. You are the art director, Michael. So do not hesitate to comment. For those of you not quite following, this is my son's rock, punk rock album cover that I'm working on, and my son is among those watching on Twitch. Looking good. You happy, Michael? Is it looking good? I'm coming up on 3 hours on this so far. I would have guessed that this is more like a 4 or 5 hour job. I think, you know, a big reason that bands don't have nice art covers like this is that they don't have a cartoonist dad. And if you're going to hire somebody for this, hire me to do this, I would want a nice paycheck that I think is out of range for most bands. Yeah, I'm not, all I'm getting on Twitch is just the chat box. I don't have a Twitch window open because I don't want to have too many, stresses and strains on my own connection here while I'm trying to get OBS to broadcast. So I don't see anything like how many people are watching on Twitch. Well, it looks to me like I've got such a big blank space happening on his upper arm that I'm going to need to give this Air Force logo more emphasis than I think it actually has on your actual arm, Michael. To deal with the space. Hey, you folks on YouTube that are not saying anything, really would appreciate your subscribing to my feed, liking my feed. Or if you are really generous, go over and watch me on twitch.tv/DarylCagle or on the front page of Cagle.com where we have a pop-up window. And subscribe to me, follow me on Twitch. I would appreciate that because that's the where I'm trying to get the live feed to work. And for Twitch to give me a partnership, they want me to have 100 subscribers, which seems like quite a hurdle to come up with at the beginning when I don't have an audience. There's a bit of a catch-22 is for them to feature you and hope you get audience, you have to already have audience. Haven't quite figured that one out. Michael, get your friends to subscribe to me while I'm here drawing your album cover. Hey, Michael, post your links to your music again. In a while, those folks probably are gone, and the new people haven't seen it. Give a bit more insight into what the heck I'm drawing. Okay, big Air Force symbol on arm. How to handle that? Ah, very good, Michael. Excuse me just a second. Kidscoop News writes, how long do you typically spend working on a single political cartoon? Well, you know, you can't just count the time that I'm sitting there drawing, because I spend all this time reading a couple newspapers a day and following all the stuff and figuring things out and then doing all the business stuff with it. The actual drawing time is the least of it. But you can watch my previous feeds and you can see how long it takes. I'd say it takes anywhere from 2.5 hours at the shortest, including coloring time, to about 8 hours per cartoon, including coloring time. Oh, I see. There's 6 people watching on Twitch. And 5 people watching on YouTube. Probably a couple less than that, since I have to count myself. One thing about the live streaming is that I don't watch as many talking heads on TV as I used to. Since I'm sitting in a quiet room, with no TV on. Oh, people are going to watch this without seeing the chat window, so I should mention that Michael's album is at punkrockopera.bandcamp.com/releases. So when you're watching this on YouTube, hello Cocoa Butter 82, nice to see you here. Kidscoop News on YouTube writes, do you prefer seeing your completed work online or in print? Well, I design it for print. And our paying customers are print customers. So, and I do still like the way drawings look on paper, printed on nicely on paper. So I'll go with print. And also, I'm an old codger. People like to come onto Twitch and point out the old gray beard. I think I would be expected to like print better. Cool Butter 82 writes, I have the same pencils, but I can't draw like you. Oh, well. Everybody's different. Hello, Brian and Deanna. Nice to see you here again. Time Waster. Cocoa Butter writes, I wish I saw you draw the hair. I really need to work on that. Well, lots of people just scritchy scratch hair, and what you need to do is really think your hair through, and as you're drawing it, think about how it feels and where the light source is, and how it falls in clumps rather than regular bits, and how it defines the volume of the form. And if you think about the hair thoroughly while you're drawing it, that's a big help. Drawing is really all about thinking of what you're drawing and feeling it in three dimensions. Unless you're a young web cartoonist who just draws stick figures. And I'm afraid that a lot of people can get away with just drawing the stick figures. Not as much respect for drawing as there used to be, I regret to say. I used to love the old Mad magazine. I used to love the comic books. I used to draw all the time and develop my skills. And kids now, they look at memes and kitties, and they play video games. And the only comic book stuff they do is going to the movies. Funny, I'm the old gray-haired man on Twitch. Like I'm complaining at all the kids to get off my lawn. as a kind of a design detail that goes like that. That I wouldn't have expected to put in had I not been looking at the photo scrap. Scoop News writes, can you repeat the URL where the completed album cover will appear? I'm not sure where it'll appear. Michael gave a URL for here. Let's do that. It's punkrockopera.bandcamp.com/releases. punkrockopera.bandcamp.com/releases. You can listen to the music that looks just like what I'm drawing. Ah, Michael, see, the question came from YouTube, where they don't see what you're posting in the chat box on Twitch. Kids Scoop writes, thanks, looks so fantastic so far. Well, thank you for the kind words, Kids Scoop News. This logo is changing a bit from what it really looks like. I'm making it bigger and a little bit more descriptive of the volume. I think it needed that. Yes, Mac Cagle is my son who is being depicted on this album cover, and this is his punk rock opera that I'm drawing. And when I finish drawing this guy, I'm going to draw Michael's logo. This is Michael's logo, punk rock opera, but I'm going to draw it in my hand so it will look more interesting than this stinking just a font. And then we're going to put it small down here in the corner. At least that's the plan. So all of you 10 people that are on Twitch, please, please, please subscribe. Because I don't have enough people watching these things. Itchy Brow 12, thank you for the kind words. So Itchy Brow, you're late to join us. This is I'm drawing punk rock CD cover. For my son the punk rocker. He really doesn't have quite this much hair, but he's close. The hair is not that much of an exaggeration. Oh, thank you for subscribing, Cocoa Butter. Next time I do a live stream, I should have the dancing taco going for when we get a new subscription. So one of the instructions from my art director son here is that the background should resolve to black so that he can print this on black t-shirts. I appreciate you, Cocoa Butter. Hello, Shuri Land. Nice to see you here. We're picking up a few people on Twitch. It's nice. Shuri Land, please subscribe. I'm hurting for subscribers. Coming up on pushing 3.5 hours working on this thing. I'm gonna finish this part pretty soon. Then the next thing I need to do is trace that draw over that logo. Thanks for the kind words, Kitscoop News. It's Scoop News writes, do you ever get feedback or backlash from politicians or their subordinates? Typically, no, because if you consider what I'm doing, I'm drawing national issues, and the national debate is so big that I'm just not a significant voice. But when you draw local things, you hear back from politicians. It's fun to do local cartoons, and you can see much more what your impact is. But typically, the only time I hear from a politician on my national stuff, and that's rare, is when they want to get the original art to hang on their wall as a trophy. And one thing that's frustrating about that is that they don't care how you insulted them. The insult is just part of the trophy. And they tend to be pretty darn cheap. Starting to run out of pencils that have been sharpened. So folks, please do remember to follow me on Twitch, subscribe on Twitch. I do appreciate that. No more comments, folks? You've all gone silent. Been drawing this too long, huh? Actually, I don't think it's too unreasonable to spend 3 or 4 hours on a cartoon. Getting pretty close to finishing this. I think this is not going to be colored. It's just going to be line art. Marilyn Harmon writes, when you're done streaming, you might want to take a look at the TOS concerning streaming here and on other platform at the same time. They not want you to do that on Twitch? I know that when you're a partner, they want you to be exclusive on Twitch. But they have not endeavored to make me a partner. Thank you for the kind words, Heinz 235. Writes, what's your favorite part of the figure to draw? Well, if you go to an art school and you look at figure drawing class, a favorite part of the to draw is always naked women breasts. Those kids come out of art school without being able to draw hands and feet, but they draw great breasts. I like the hands and feet. I'm gonna need a new piece of sandpaper. Kim G on YouTube writes, all my life I've had a love-hate relationship with pencils being left-handed. I see you are one as well. Small world, Kim G. Notice that I draw from right to left, and I'm not dragging my hand through the art like I would be if I was writing a letter. And I find at the end of it all, when I've got a nice pencil drawing on vellum here, pencil drawing looks nice. Notice that little bit of shine? A little bit of shine, it's nice. It doesn't look like that to me. I mean, you're getting a kind of an odd shiny view, but because of the lighting. But I like the textural aspect of it, looking at it and knowing that it's an original. You can get a sense of where the artist was moving his hand and thinking about something. And some of the ink drawings I see are so clean that you can't tell if they're copies. Not really a hint of where the artist was futzing around thinking. Kid Scoop News writes, which cartoonist were your earliest influence? My earliest influence was Fleischer Studios. I loved Popeye. I drew lots of Popeye when I was a tiny kid. I love the old Fleischer Studios stuff. I like the olive oil kind of elbows that are rounded. My son and I had a conversation about this, and I said, can I give you a round arm that doesn't have an elbow? And he says, I need an elbow. I want a sharp elbow. And I said, but you know, it's funny if your arm goes in a curve and it's not an elbow. I want an elbow, he says. Punk rockers have sharp elbows, he says. All right. But if it was up to me, it'd be round. But I do take art direction. When it's not an editorial cartoon, I take art direction. Alright, are we close to being done? I think I finished this in just about 3.5 hours. I have yet to scan it and clean up the stuff in the Photoshop. Put in the little logo that's going to be down here in the corner. Somewhere I will reverse my signature out of it. Well, I think that's kind of where it ends up. This is the art. Let's see if that helps. That's a little better. I like that without the light on it. Maybe I should have done that to start with. Turn off all the lights. Oh, that's too much. Anyway, here it is. Finished art. My son, the punk rocker. A few more lines to draw here. What else to futz with? I do get a different view when I'm looking in the monitor. Thank you for the kind words, Kid Scoop News. Do please remember to subscribe. If you'd run over to Twitch and subscribe, that would be nice. Alright, I think he's done. That is the end, folks. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to scan this and make it pretty as line art in Photoshop. Drop in that logo that I haven't quite drawn yet. And this will be finished. I'm not going to clean it up too much in Photoshop because he's a punk rocker, you know? It's supposed to be kind of grungy. Anyway, thank you, folks. Do please remember to subscribe. I appreciate your time sitting with me all afternoon here. And join me for the next one. I put out a notice on my Facebook page and Twitter when I'm going to do a new stream. So please come take a look. I'm continuing to futz with little details here. Anyway, thank you for your time and for watching, and I will see you with the next stream. Thank you so much, folks.